Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Gabriella Nagy. I'm a fifth level image therapist. I live in and work in Hungary, in the eastern part of Hungary, in Debrecen and Hajdudorog. I graduated from Kundawell Medical Research Institute in January 2017, and I attended my first image medicine seminar with Professor Suming Tang in Slovakia in 2015. And since then, I have been using the methods of Chinese image medicine. I'm still at the very beginning of my journey in the field of image medicine, but I'm very happy that I found this method because this is so wonderful and it can help so much to people. I would like to talk about two cases. The first case is about a 26 years old young woman, a young lady. She is a university student, she studies law. She was diagnosed with severe migraine. Her problem started when she was 11 years old, a small girl. She often had very strong headaches. She was given painkillers first and they helped for the time being, but as the time flied by, these migraines attacks, these headaches came more and more often, very frequently. And in 2011, she was diagnosed with migraine. She had very strong pain every day. She had nausea. Sometimes she even vomited. She had bumbus noise in her ear. And she couldn't eat properly. She couldn't see very well when these attacks came. And another symptom was that she had spasmic pain in her abdomen, both in the upper part and both in the lower part. And also she had a strong spasm during menstruation. By the time we met, she couldn't live a normal life. It was very difficult for her because she couldn't do her studies well and couldn't work, couldn't go out. She stayed at home most of the time. She told me that last summer she was lying on her bed most of the time, the whole summer. She had a lot of examinations, MRI, EEG, EKG. She went to see a migraine specialist during these long years. She received a lot of medications. She had to take a lot of medicine. But the doctors couldn't find the reason for this problem. She heard about image medicine, heard about me, and came to see me. She thought she would give it a try. Maybe it helps something, helps her a bit. She had a lot of medical, Western medicine diagnoses. I brought you only two of them. They are speak about their symptoms and the medications she received. When we met and when I diagnosed her, she was quite tired. And she was very sad and she wasn't optimistic at all. And I was also sad to see a young girl in this status. Then I diagnosed her. I used the pulse diagnosis. And at physical level, I could feel that her heart was beating very, very strong. At energy level, I could feel that her kidneys were ice cold. Also, the urine bladder was very cold and also dark. The liver and the gallbladder were warm and they were vibrating. And I felt that her head was warm too. So the liver's energy went up to her head. The spleen's energy was weak and the lungs were cool. There was only weak connection between her kidneys and liver, liver and gallbladder, kidneys and heart. The energy circulation wasn't good at all in the body. At information level, I found a lot of fear and anger connected to sexuality. And also I could feel that she was worried that she, could she be good enough for her father. When we started our healing sessions, I started with the activation of the four points around the navel. Then I took out the coldness from the body. Then I pat the whole body and opened all the channels. I woke up kidneys, urine bladder, liver, and all the organs using bigger, smaller method. Connected the organs to each other, used mantra tung to create this connection. Check the information and images and use mantra kung and so to remove bad information and images from the body. Clean the liver and kidneys using mantra hua. Regenerated and changed the image of the kidneys and urine bladder. clean bad images from the urine bladder using mantra kungan. So use mantra ming to fill the body with light and clean it. Use mantra bian to change the heart's arrhythmia, also word with acupuncture pericardium 6. And we were talking, and she told me that she was sexually abused. And yes, it was true that she wanted to be good enough for her father, that her father would be satisfied. After the fifth treatment, the pain in the abdomen disappeared. After the seventh treatment, the migraine came only twice or three times a week. There were no side problems. Her bum was reduced. After the ninth treatment, nausea disappeared too. The migraine became a headache, which came less often now. She is able to eat properly and sleeps much better. Her mood changed. She last summer, she went on a holiday with her family, so that was a big change for her. Now she doesn't have a strong pain during menstruation either. She takes much less medicine now. She has started to practice Zhong Yuan Qigong and will start working and wants to finish university this year. We continue working together to reach full recovery, and I hope it will come soon. This is her present status. The present status is marked in red. It's telling about having much less medication and much better, that she is in much better state. Her case shows us how effective image medicine is, because I could help a person who didn't have hope. She visited so many clinics, hospitals, doctors, and nothing helped her. And it was very difficult. And she was very, very, very surprised and very happy when her status started to improve and she started to feel much better. It was wonderful. I was very happy too, of course. The second case is about a woman. She is 42 years old. She works in healthcare, and she is married. She has a daughter. In 2016, she was diagnosed with cervical precancer status. She had the CIN test, and it was the second level. And they had some further tests and found HPV virus infection. She was operated. A part of the cervix was cut and removed. After the operation, the results were good. Her results were good. And she regularly had to go to take tests again. And last year, 2018, she had the same result again, the pre-cervical cancer status, the CIN test second level. Doctors told her that she needs a new operation. This is the diagnosis from last year. And when I diagnosed her with the method of image medicine, I could feel that at energy level, I could feel that the urine bladder and the uterus was dark and cold. And also the kidneys were very cold and had low energy. Spleen was weak and dark, liver was vibrating, and lungs were weak too. The connection between uterus and heart, kidneys and lungs, spleen and liver, spleen and kidneys were weak. At information level, I could feel sorrow, fear, and anger. When we started the healing process, first I pat her arms and legs to open the energy channels, took out coldness from the urine bladder and kidneys, woke up urine bladder, kidneys, liver, and spleen using bigger, smaller method. Restored the connection between the organs, uterus and heart, kidneys and lungs, spleen and liver, spleen and kidneys, using mantra Tung and BM. Changed the image of the uterus and regenerated it. Used the red fireball to clean the cervix. After this treatment, she had a very high fever for one night. When I second time used this red fireball, she had only a small fever, and for the third time, she didn't have fever at all. Cleaned the bad images from the urine bladder and heart using mantra Kung and Zhou. Changed the image of the spleen and regenerated it. Cleaned the liver using mantra Hua. I talked with her about her emotions, and I learned that she lost her first husband in a tragic way. He committed suicide. And this woman was left alone with her child, and she had to provide everything for her daughter. She had to be the father and the mother in the family. It was a very difficult time, so we had to change this information too. the result, we had 10 healing sessions together. She loved these sessions because she was very, very relaxed. And quite a lot of times she even fell asleep during the treatment process. It helped her to balance the yin-yang in her body and get rid of stress. She went back for a new test in March this year, 2019, and again in July. And the new test didn't show any problem. The operation is not needed. She will have to go back for test again every 6 months. We both were very happy to see these results. She also practices Zhong Yuan Qigong regularly. This is the new medical diagnosis. It shows that everything is negative, no problem at all. This again shows us how effective image medicine is, because we reached this result without operation, medication, without pain, and without side effects. This is a great thing, I believe. So I think that image medicine should reach all the people in the world and every family, because we can help so much with this method that everybody needs to know it and use it. I would like to say thank you to Professor Siming Tang and Kundawell Medical Research Institute to make it possible for us to learn image medicine and to use it. Thank you for your attention.